teachers. Welcome back to our PowerPoint presentation class. And today, we are going to speak about effective use of PowerPoint in teaching and learning. Take a piece of paper and pen and do this question. How do you think you can engage your student while teaching in a class using a PowerPoint and a projector? Okay, I hope everybody have come up with different answers and different ideas on how we can engage our students while teaching in a class using a PowerPoint and a projector. Now let's discuss how can we engage our students in a class using a PowerPoint and a projector. The first thing you have to do here, make a slide text very simple. Do not be too wordy in your slides, this will be boring and the students cannot concentrate in whatever you are presenting to them. Make the design and art of your presenting very attractive and very interactive to the student. The art and the design of your presentation is the first key to put attention of your student in the class and in your presentation. So make sure the design and the art of your presentation work very attractive to the student and very interactive. The third thing, allow to add pictures, videos, simulation, and other things to support your content. Do not put irrelevant content in your presentation. This will be boring and the student cannot understand. Also, the objective will not be achieved. The fourth thing, allow students to take notes after you speak or after you stop talking. When you are just making a presentation, the one mistake we don't have to do is to allow students to take notes while you are talking. This will make them not understand anything of your presentation. So make sure after you speak or after you finish talking, then allow them to take notes. The fifth one, put engaging questions. Whatever you are teaching, or it's mathematics, or it's chemistry, or biology, put those interactive questions in your presentation. Example, let's say I'm teaching water chemistry and I want my student to engage in my class. I can put this question: what causes water hardness? So the student will come up with a discussion and they give me the answers on what causes the water hardness. The sixth thing is give feedback to your students. Allow your student to be given feedback in whatever you've been given them. Either it's a work, it's a question, or anything while teaching in a class. So the feedback will put clarification of all the doubts they have in presentation, and the engagement and interaction of your student will be good, even if the next time you come up with a presentation, they'll be very interested. And the last thing, do not forget to put sequential order of your presentation. Make sure the sequence of your presentation is very good and very understandable to your children. Because if the sequence is not good, also the content will be mixed, so they will not understand what your objective or what your aim of teaching that thing in the class, because they will come up at the end of the class or at the end of the session, they have not yet understood anything. I hope you understood. If you have any question or any doubts about anything in the presentation, go in a discussion forum and post whatever you have. If it's a question, comments, views, or option or opinion, share it with another teachers and other teaching assistants. Thank you so much. I wish a good night.